It's been said that play is kids' work, and maybe not just kids. Playing can give children and adults a healthy boost in endorphins, the feel-good hormones. Children's lifestyle expert Patty Sullivan is involved with thegeniusofplay.org. Thanks very much for joining us this afternoon, Patty.
Absolutely.
Now, a lot of kids this year, of course, aren't at summer camp because of the pandemic. So how is the Genius of Play filling that gap?
Well, the Genius of Play is a nonprofit initiative whose mission is to educate parents and caregivers about all the benefits of play, and there are many. Now, the big thing about their website, thegeniusofplay.org, is that they have hundreds of free resources for families. They work with over 50 education experts and child development experts on the content, so you know it is all grounded in research. And according to research, play has six key benefits for child development, and those include cognitive, communication, creativity, social, emotional, and physical. Now, you mentioned adults off the top. Research also shows that play helps us to decompress, to relieve stress, to relieve anxiety, and to stay positive, and all those things are very important at a time like this.
Thegeniusofplay.org,
yes, is a great go-to place for all those things about play, including play ideas.
Of course. Speaking of play ideas, we've heard of the STEM activities, science, technology, engineering, and math.
You guys have some... one. STEAM.
Yeah, you have STEAM. Okay, what's STEAM then?
STEAM is science, tech, engineering, arts, and math. So all of those things, those activities, games, toys, are a great thing for kids to be doing anytime, really, because it inspires them to learn, and kids are hardwired to learn. I don't know if you know that. And so while they are playing, they're also learning. It's a great supplement to the classroom learning, but they're having fun, so they don't realize that they're also learning problem solving and critical thinking and focus. This one that you see right now is like making your own lava lamp. It's so easy, it's not hard. You can use things around the house. You can make your own volcano. You can make foam and slime. Sensory activities are also great for relieving stress. So STEAM activities, toys, games, a great one for kids and parents too. It's a lot of fun.
Okay, you just mentioned the sensory activities, and that's kind of getting your hands dirty, right?
Yeah, dough, slime, foam, even going outside and playing in the dirt, in the mud. That's all stress relief, but fun and play, and kids and parents can do that together.
Mm-hmm. What age group is this geared toward?
Well, the Genius of Play, what's great about their website, thegeniusofplay.org, is everything is categorized by age. So you can look for toddlers, you can look for even 12-year-olds, and you can also check based on if you only have a certain amount of time in your day and you want them to play for 10 minutes, you can look that up. 20 minutes, you can look that up. It's all there. The other thing is there's stuff about creativity, like wear costumes and play pretend, or physical activity. You can make your own obstacle course in your house, and parents can get involved in that as well. So all of these things, you'll be learning, you'll be staying healthy, and you'll be staying positive all at the same time. So thegeniusofplay.org is an amazing site to go to. If you have no idea what to do, check it out.
Here in Calgary, we are experiencing probably the hottest week of the year. Not as hot as it is in Toronto, where you are, but it is a great opportunity for kids to get outdoors. And a lot of this stuff is outdoors, right?
There's a bit of both. So if the day is too hot for the kids, or if it's raining, if you got a thunderstorm, there's outdoor activities listed, there's indoor activities listed. Again, hundreds of different ones. There's even activity sheets that you can print off. So lots of resources. One of my favorite is a dress up. So if you have old clothes that you're going to get rid of, just throw them in a box. Let the kids play pretend. Let them put on their own little cafe. They can be the maitre d', and you can be the guest, and you can come in and you can order from them. It's a great way for them to be learning communication skills and emotional skills and cooperation. But at the same time, they're having fun, and you'll have fun too. Let them wait on you. I mean, come on. We're all so busy right now. It's a great way for kids and parents to have fun together, but for the parents to sit back and, you know, be waited on for a change.
Sure, with the added twist of your kids wearing your clothes from the 1990s, for example.
That's right. But you could also do that on your porch or your back deck if you want to go outside.
Sounds like tons of fun. Thanks very much, Patty. Thank you for joining us.
You're welcome.
And for more information, you can check out the website, thegeniusofplay.org. The organization is also on Facebook and Instagram.